Welcome to this new Inside Code video where we will discuss an interesting problem. It's the next greater number problem. In this one, we are given a positive integer num and we are asked to return the next greater integer that we can make from its digits. In other words, the integer that comes just after it that is made with the same digits. So if for example we have num equal to 231, we have to return 312. Which is the next greater integer that is made using the digits 2, 3, and 1. And if num is already the greatest integer that we can make, it means that there is no next greater integer, so the function must return num itself. You can pause the video if you want to try to solve the problem, and you can click on the link in the description to be able to try the input you want and get the expected output. Now, let's start solving this problem. You have to know that finding the pattern of how we can move from num to the next greater one is quite hard to find. I personally had to try and analyze many inputs to be able to notice it. But once you do, you just have to implement it in code. But in reality, you can solve this problem without finding that pattern. Because when we read next greater, we can directly think of a sorted array where num is at the index I and the number we're searching for is at the index I plus 1. And if num is at the last index, it means that there is no greater element, so we return it. And the array we're talking about is an array that contains all the possible integers that we can make from the digits of num. In other words, all the possible permutations. So if we take our first example, which is when num is equal to 231, the sorted array will contain all the possible permutations of 2, 3, 1, which are 123, 132, 213, 231, 312, and 321. And after getting that array, we search for num, here is it in our example, and the next greater is just after it, so we return permutations of I plus 1. Except if num is the last element, in that case we return num. But the problem with this solution is its time complexity, which is order n factorial, where n represents the number of digits of num, which is really slow and inefficient, so we consider this solution as a brute force solution, also called naive solution. Why is it order n factorial? Because you have to know that when we have n elements, we can make until n factorial permutations, and in our case, num has n digits, so in the worst case, there is n factorial possible numbers that we can make from those n digits. And we need order n factorial complexity to generate all of them, which is very inefficient. For example, if num had only 10 digits, there could be more than 3 million permutations, so we need to find another solution. And here is where the difficulty starts. We need to observe well to find the pattern. Let's analyze this example. We have num is equal to this number and the output is below. First of all, we can notice that it's not the whole number who changed. We rearranged only the last 5 digits, and the last digit we changed is this one. But why? Why did we stop there? This is what we're gonna see now. If we try to modify only the last digit, we can't make a greater number. If we try to modify only the last 2 digits, same thing, we can't make a greater number, because 40 is the greatest number that we can make with the digits 4 and 0. Let's try with the last 3 digits, same problem, we can't make a greater number. 540 is the greatest one. Last 4 digits, same thing, we can't. Last 5 digits, here we can make a greater number by rearranging the last 5 digits, and we get 40,158, because it's the next greater number that comes after 80,540. But we don't concretely know when to stop, when to know that we arrive to the last digit that will be changed, and for that, let's represent the digits in a line graph. And we can clearly see that the last digit that's gonna be modified is the one that breaks the ascending order. Because digits from the right form an ascending series of digits. And the one that breaks this order is the last digit that will be changed. So we read the digits from the right, and as soon as we find an element digits of I that is smaller than digits of I plus 1, we break the loop. And our last digit is at the index I. Except if I becomes equal to minus 1, which means that all the digits of num are in ascending order. In other words, there is no way to make a greater number than num, so we return num, it's the edge case of the problem we've talked about. But in the general case, it means that we found the last digit. But with which value is it gonna be swapped? This is the next step of this algorithm. Don't forget that our goal is to get the next greater number. So even if we change the value of 1 here, we have to make it the closest possible to 1. And for that, we start reading digits from the right, that are in ascending order, don't forget, and as soon as we find a digit that is strictly greater than our last digit, which is 4 in our case, we swap with it. Now that we finished this step, we move to the next one, because you can see that we didn't arrive to our expected output yet. We still have the last 4 digits to rearrange. But how we will do that? For that, I'll let you compare between the last 4 digits of our actual number and the last 4 digits of the expected output. Take 5 seconds to try to find the relation between them. We can notice that to arrive to our expected output, we just have to reverse the last 4 digits, and we finally get our expected output, so we return it. And this solution is way more efficient, because we just had to iterate over digits, so the time complexity is order of n. Same thing for the space complexity, it's order of n, because we needed an array to store the n digits of num. Let's now have a look on the algorithm. First of all, we store the digits of num in an array that we can, for example, call digits. It makes it easier to iterate over digits, to swap, and things like that. Second thing, we need to find the position of the last element that will be changed, because we will swap it later, so we need to know its position. And for that, we start at the before last element, and we keep iterating while I is greater than or equal to 0, to avoid going out of bounds, and while digits of I is greater than or equal to digits of I plus 1, which means that the order is still ascending, remember. We start at the before last element and not the last one, because the last one has no next element, so we would get an error when evaluating digits of I plus 1. After this loop, we said that if I is minus 1, it means that all the digits are in ascending order, so there is no next greater number, we just return num. Third step, we need to find the value that will be swapped with digits of I, and for that, we iterate over the digits starting from the right with a variable g. And while digits of g is smaller than or equal to digits of I, we keep decrementing g to move to the next digit, because we want to stop as soon as we find a digit that is greater than digits of I. Fourth step, now after finding the value of g, the position, we can swap digits of I with digits of g, as seen before. And last step now, we have to reverse the last part of the array as seen earlier, and that part starts at the index I plus 1, so we reverse the part of digits that starts at the index I plus 1. And now that digits contain the expected output, we return it as an integer again. We finally finished. I hope that you understood the solution of this problem, which is a bit tricky, and you can find the commented code of this solution in Python, C++, Java, and JavaScript by clicking on the first link in the description. See you in the next video.